Hey everyone, Dr. Kuntz here, and welcome back to Pr1me Time. I'm the founder and owner of Pr1me Movement, and in this Pr1me Time session, episode number 4, we're going to discuss how to avoid injuries, staleness, and plateaus in your workout training regimen. So let's get right into it. Let's be honest, we could spend probably a full week discussing it, so I'm going to try to cover as much information as I can within the next 5 minutes. How to avoid injuries. So understand this. There are good exercises out there, there are bad exercises out there, and there are good exercises done poorly. I'd like to think that a lot of people that I work with have good intentions and they have good exercises, but they're doing them poorly. From whatever clinical belief system they've gathered, from whoever taught them, maybe they've just made mistakes over time and haven't realized it, or maybe just based off their anatomy, certain techniques aren't right for them that they've been taught from before. So we have to make sure that you're doing the exercises correctly and that the exercises are geared for where you're at in your current health and fitness state, if that makes sense. AKA, a beginner's level of exercises will be much different than a master's. Another way to avoid injuries is to make sure that you regularly incorporate a deload week. If you haven't heard or have been incorporating a deload week, tune in right now. A deload week is a purposeful time period where you deliberately rest and or decrease intensity and or volume in your training regimen so that you can recover and rejuvenate in order to continue to progress. So really what we're trying to do in your workout training regimen is functionally overreach, okay? You're actually trying to take yourself above and beyond in your progressive overload mesocycle or in your workout program for those 3 to 4 weeks. However, it's not sustainable, or it shouldn't be. If it is sustainable, then that makes me question if you're actually working hard enough or pushing yourself enough, or why you're not doing that. I'd want to have that conversation. But nonetheless, after those 3 to 4 weeks, 4 to 5 weeks, kind of in that time frame, that's when you incorporate the deload week. Remember, you grow not during the stimulus, like not during when you work out, but when you sleep and when you recover. Think about a deload week as that opportunity to recover from that 4 to 5 week workout program that you've been undergoing. If a program's done right, you're actually targeting specific fibers and tendons and muscles throughout the full 4 weeks. You're not continuing to change workouts all the time. You wouldn't be giving it that repeated bout of stimulus that you need. Therefore, your body will need time to recover exactly where you've been working hard at it. Okay. Understand that if you change your workouts all the time, it's not necessarily bad. Just know that you're not going to get the most out of that stimulus. While it's good to probably attenuate fatigue, it's not for specific growth of that muscle. So that covers injuries. Staleness. I'm going to go right back into deload week. So you should be creating workout programs or being under the guidance of someone, some healthcare professional who understands how to write workout programs so that you could change and alter your workout programs. So I like a deload for my clients after about the fourth week. That fifth week is a deload week. They continue on their regimen up until about the 10th week. We give them another deload week then. And then we give them a whole new workout program. That, my friends, helps keep staleness out of the picture, because you're excited. You've actually had a couple chances to go through deload weeks, and I've written more about that in my Dr. Kuntz's Ultimate Weightlifting Starter Kit. I'll be happy to attach the link, and there's a lot more information on that deload week, but that alone gives people a good chance to kind of have that stimulus, that psychological, mental stimulus, if you will, getting ready to prep for the upcoming program, especially when we alter that program, which can be incredibly exciting and motivating, and as you're seeing results. And lastly, how to break through plateaus. Again, we need to be undulating, changing your workout programs and being specific for your goals in mind. If you want to lose 30 pounds versus put on 20 pounds versus a football athlete versus a golf athlete, we might all have different goals in mind. So folks, I hope that helps with the understanding of how to incorporate deload weeks and how to avoid injuries, staleness, and plateaus. As always, thank you for tuning in to Pr1me Time. See you guys next time.